Hi, I'm David Bianco. Welcome back to the Sound of Safe and Sound Texas. Today, it's an artist profile. A voice that has haunted me for decades, literally, Miss Karen Carpenter. A life full of tragedy, but yet a voice so heavenly. We'll focus on it next on the Sound of Safe and Sound Texas.
Like sailing on.
Welcome back, everybody. Today we're going to be doing an artist profile on Karen Carpenter. We all have times in our life where we say we remember where we were when certain things happened. Boy, and I certainly remember where I was and what I was doing when I heard on the radio that she had died. That was a total shock to me and a really big loss. What a waste. Such a talent, such a voice. And in honor of her, I'm going to be dissecting a bit some of her vocals. I've gotten some very good, high-quality audio clips and some that are more a cappella with a little less instrumentation behind it so that you can really zoom in on listening to her voice. I'd suggest, if you can, listening on headphones because I think you get a much better feeling of how her voice was very mature and it was very crisp and really one that really stands out in the industry of anybody that I can recall in the last 30 to 40 years. And so I want to give you some examples like this one.
Why do birds suddenly appear every time you are near? Just like me, they long to be close to you. Why do stars fall down from the sky every time you walk by? Just like me, they long to be close to you.
As many of you may know, Karen was not only a fabulous vocalist, but she also played the drums, and she was darn good. It's amazing to me, on a lot of the tracks that they did early on, she played drums and did the vocals, and those were some of the cuts they actually used on the records. Amazing. I really think you could hear a lot of clarity in her voice. You could hear the texture of it. There's even kind of what I call the dampness of her voice and the movement of her mouth that you can pick up. And that to me is a technique and a style and a voice that is not often captured. It's also an indication of very good equipment that was used. But I just think that her voice was one that we just really never could appreciate well enough. And some of these new updated techniques to get a little more of her voice pulled out away from all the instrumentation really shows it. Here's another example.
Greeting cards have all been sent. The Christmas rushes through. But I still have one wish to make, a special one for you. Merry Christmas, darling. We're apart, that's true. But I can dream, and in my dream I'm Christmasing with you.
So there's an example, a Christmas classic, Merry Christmas, Darling. That vocal being pulled out of there is just so distinct and so clear. You just recognize how much impact that has really had and how much the instruments, you know, when they're there, I think they sometimes take away from that in the sense that you really can't appreciate it. So it's throughout her catalog as a whole. So here's another example.
When I was young, I'd listen to the radio, waiting for my favorite songs. When they played, I'd sing along. It made me smile.
Well, Karen, your vocals certainly made us smile. I think a lot of the production work that Richard Carpenter did, which was fabulous throughout all of the catalog, a lot of times really overwhelmed sometimes her voice. There was also the echoing effect that they did and the double tracking that they did of her voice that also added a certain depth to it and a certain presence. But when we really want to listen to her voice standing alone and really in those quieter moments and in the places where she can really be precise, this is where it really stands out. Here's another really great example from the song Solitaire.
A little hope goes up in smoke, just how it goes, goes without saying.
Say, Karen Carpenter. Examples go on, but these are a few that really pop out at me, and they're higher quality. I wanted you to be able to listen to the isolated voice and think about what she brought to the music industry. Really could have done a lot more, I'm sure, if she had lived longer. Unfortunately, as often happens in rock music and pop music and in the life of entertainment, sometimes things don't always work out the way we wish they would have. But this has been a great journey for me, a great reminiscing. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like this video and subscribe also. And if you have any comments, I'd love to hear from them as well. So for now, thanks for watching and see you soon on the Sound of Safe and Sound, Texas.